patients with HPV-positive oropharynx tumors generally do much better than patients with HPV-negative tumors. And we think that's driven by human papillomavirus. However, we think there's variation within human papillomavirus among the HPV-positive tumors. And we wanted to explore that and understand this variation among HPV-positive tumors to see if we could use it clinically or translationally to understand the biology or find new targets or biomarkers. The HPV-positive oropharynx cancer patients generally have very good long-term survival, but they often have significant long-term morbidity, where they have problems with speech and swallowing long-term due to the intense radiation therapy that they're usually given. So there's a big push in the field to reduce the intensity of radiation therapy. It's called de-escalation, and reduce the amount of radiation to reduce the side effects that these patients will suffer from long-term. However, to do that safely, you should only reduce treatment on the most low-risk patients. And right now, there are no biomarkers or molecular markers to determine who's low risk and who's not. So we were hoping to understand the biology of HPV and use that to figure out which patients are low risk or which patients are high risk, and potentially further understand the biology to find new ways to treat them or to reduce treatment intensity. We examined a cohort of HPV-positive tumors from the Cancer Genome Atlas Project, or TCGA, and we found variations within the HPV-positive tumors. And we found this by looking at the level of HPV as a continuous variable instead of what's called a discrete variable. So instead of looking at tumors as HPV-positive or HPV-negative, we looked at a range of HPV positivity based on gene expression. And this allowed us to find a variety of human genes associated with that level of HPV within the tumors. And that led us to a set of human biology, a set of genes linked to human biology that, it turns out, are highly associated with the function of HPV in those tumors, and somewhat to our surprise, with outcome of the patients. So we found that these genes linked with HPV function could identify a subset of patients who do very poorly and another subset who do very well. We've found some new fundamental aspects of human papilloma virus biology. And one of them is that the variations we see in HPV function are not linked to the canonical driving oncogenes of human papillomavirus. These genes are called E6 and E7. And they're the genes everyone studies as how HPV is carcinogenic or how it drives cancer. We actually linked the biology to a different gene, E1, E4. That is very understudied in cancer. And if it's confirmed that this functionally is driving the phenotypes we're seeing, we've identified a new aspect of HPV biology that's understudied and could reveal new avenues for therapeutic intervention or new aspects of the biology of these tumors. This study matters because we're hoping it will lead to improvements in the care of HPV-positive patients, that we may soon have a biomarker that can say, you are a low-risk patient, we can de-escalate therapy on you and hopefully have less side effects, but still have good outcome. Conversely, we may be able to say that your tumor is likely to be very aggressive and you won't respond to standard therapy, and we should give you more therapy or put you on a clinical trial right away.